Let's look at the solution to our coherence definition quiz, where we had two cores running in a coherence system executing some code, and the question was basically which of these five possibilities for what gets printed are possible. Let's see what can happen in these two programs. If core 1 gets to go first with a equals 1, it's then going to spin here for as long as ax equal 1. So it gets stuck until core 2 does something. Eventually, however, core 2 will do a equals 0, in which case core 1 gets to continue. And now, core 1 will set a to 1. Core 2 will wait here until a is set to 1, because as long as it's set to 0, the way it set it, it's going to get stuck here. So what then happens is core 1, when it sets this, releases core 2. Now core 2 can do this and this first, while core 1 is still being delayed here. Or it can be that core 1 gets here first and then core 2 gets here. So definitely, these two outcomes are possible. They basically depend on after core 1 waits for core 2 to release it, and then it itself releases core 2, who gets to print first. Now let's see if it's possible for core 1 to never get to this point. For that to happen, core 1 needs to get stuck here in this while loop, which means that A needs to stay 1 forever. That can only occur if core 2 is done with its program and the resulting value of A is still 1, or if core 2 also gets stuck here and the resulting value of A is still 1. So core 1 is stuck here and A is 1. If that happens before core 2 gets to A equals 0, then core 2 is going to release core 1. So A equals 0 had to happen before this. If A equals 0 happened before all of this, then what happens is A equals 0, A equals 1. Now we are stuck waiting for 1. But core 2 will continue, and it has to see the 1, because this is a coherent system. Eventually, because A equals 1 happened after A equals 0, core 2 has to see the 1 and proceed. Once it proceeds, it's going to set A to 0. Core 1 has to see that because of the second part of the definition and proceed. So it's not possible to get core 1 stuck here by just moving the A equals 0 to the beginning. Now let's see if it's possible for core 2 to finish the whole thing before this happens, in which case core 1 will get stuck here. But that's not possible, because core 2 now needs to execute this whole program here before core 1 even begins. That's not possible because core 2 sets A to 0 and then waits for it to become non-zero. So core 2 cannot finish the whole thing until core 1 does at least this, at which point we are back to the first case of pretty much core 1 will eventually see that the A is 0 because core 2 set it that way after A became 1. It's also important to notice that it's not possible for example, A equals 1 and A equals 2 to happen one after the other. And then core 1 thinks that this was the last write, so it gets stuck here, while core 2 thinks this was the last write and then gets stuck here. Because the third part of the coherence definition says that both of them have to think that the same axis was the last one. So if they agree that this was the last one, then this core gets released and then ends up releasing the first one. If they think this was the last access, then this core gets to be released and releases the second one. So either way, it's not possible to get any of the three printouts. In an incoherent system, it can easily happen that you get these or any of these other three. So for example, nothing can be printed then by simply storing one to the cache and then never really checking anything else, just looping on the value in the cache here. Meanwhile, this one stores another value in its own cache, then just infinitely spins on it. And then you can get the other two possibilities here by simply one of them not being entirely incoherent. So as you can see, a coherent system prevents some of the behaviors that are possible in an incoherent system, but all the behaviors that are possible in the coherent system are also possible in an incoherent one. So coherence is allowed in an incoherent system. It's just that incoherent systems don't guarantee that all their behaviors are going to be coherent.